also. And you can only imagine what the year must have been like for him. I mean, his bread and butter is fireworks, and all the fireworks shows last year were canceled. So what did he do, and what's he doing this year? We'll talk with him in just a second. Right now, let's take a look at your drive on the 101.
We're looking at Echo Park this time on the 101 southbound just before Alvarado. It's a solo car spin out. Somebody hit the center divider, bounced back into the left lane. They stopped all the lanes for a little bit. The drive now stacking up right around Silver Lake. In Hollywood on the 101, the northbound side, just before Santa Monica Boulevard, three-car smash up in the two left lanes. So expect that delay at Melrose. Downtown Los Angeles on the 110 south at 8th Street. On the off-ramp, there's a car that lost a tire, so they're kind of sitting there waiting for a little bit of help. And Cerritos, a stalled-out motorcycle in the center divider if you're traveling on the 91 westbound right at Norwalk Boulevard. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robin Banks.
This report is sponsored by Avello Airlines. Just graduated this year like I did? Then grab your travel bud for an epic trip. Avello Airlines is giving away 500 round-trip tickets to celebrate the class of 2021, because we deserve it. Register in Avello before July 20th. Restrictions may apply. Visit AvelloAir.com.
This is Doug Allen. Here's what's trending from the iHeart Sports Network.
It's on the back Altran. See you work down alert.
Shakiri Richardson may miss the Tokyo Olympics after testing positive for marijuana. The American sprinter won the 100-meter race the track and field trial. Dodgers manager Dave Roberts said Trevor Bauer will start Sunday despite his sexual assault allegations. And former USC star Reggie Bush wants his Heisman Trophy back. The move comes after the NCAA granted rights for college athletes to profit off their name, image, and likeness. I'm Missy Jordan.
Every day, Caltrans workers risk their lives to make our roads safe. They are someone's loved one. Please use extra caution when you drive through a work zone. Always be work zone alert.
Rates subject to change without notice. Minimum loan amount requirements apply. 60% loan to value and 620 FICO credit score. Certain restrictions apply. Subject to credit approval. NMLS 3290. Loans made or arranged pursuant to a California Finance Lenders Law License number 603-6970. Equal housing lender.
It is Friday on a holiday weekend, so wake up. I know that you've heard all these great home loan rates being advertised, and maybe you've thought to yourself, man, I would love to get one of those. I could really use that money. But maybe you've thought, sounds like a great idea, but I know I don't qualify. Well, I bet you haven't called the folks at IntelliLoan, because right now IntelliLoan is offering a 1.99% APR with no points or no lender fees, and this is even if your credit score is 620, and sometimes it's that, I don't know if my credit score is that great, that makes people a little hesitant to call. Call IntelliLoan. Even if you're self-employed, whatever it is, IntelliLoan can help you get that great home loan. And it's a 1.99% APR with no points or no lender fees that they're offering right now. And this is even if your credit score is 620. So call IntelliLoan before those rates go up. Call them at 1-800-918-6200. That's 1-800-918-6200. Or just go to IntelliLoan.com.
IntelliLoan. Borrow smart.
Before I started Rooter Hero Plumbing, I was an angry young man. Hello, I'm John McClan. I was angry because my dad died when I was 17 and he left me alone. I was angry because I couldn't go to college with my friends and because I had to drop out of high school. It's not a pleasant story. But as I grew older, I also grew up. I realized that my dad didn't leave me alone. He left me with values and principles that continue to shape my life. Dad said, be on time. He didn't like it when people were late. He taught me to be polite. It was something I lost, but we captured along the way. And he taught me to keep my promises, because broken promises lead to broken relationships. We teach and keep these values at Rooter Hero Plumbing. I think we have a pretty good company. I know we have great people. And if one of our heroes fails to live up to these values, please call me. My private number is on the back of every Rooter Hero business card. You can also reach us at rooterhero.com. Thank you.
Rick Edelman, number one New York Times bestselling author and founder of Edelman Financial Engines, takes questions on his radio show.
Hi, Rick. I have a pension and can take it as monthly income or a lump sum. Which do you think is better?
Well, the monthly check is only as safe as your employer's ability to pay it. I mean, that will never rise, so inflation will erode its value. You have no access to the principal, and when you die, the money stops, even if you die tomorrow. So we usually recommend the lump sum. You get to invest the money however you want and generate your own income. You have full access anytime, and whatever's left over goes to your spouse or kids. But for some workers, the monthly option is better. so you should meet with a financial advisor to be sure that you're doing what's best for you.
That's Rick Edelman, founder of Edelman Financial Engines, with his advice on pensions. If you have a personal finance question, talk to an experienced financial planner at 888-PLAN-RICK or visit rickedelman.com.
When it comes to protecting your business from fire, Bay Alarm brings the best. Like industry-leading fire detection systems, monitored 24/7, Bay Alarm puts the pro in fire protection. Now, more than ever, Bay Alarm. ACO28CCO880138.
Get sizzling solar savings now with Semper Solaris, your local veteran-owned solar and battery storage contractor. Being veteran-owned matters. Here's veteran, founder, and owner, Kelly Shawhan.
In the military, when you give your word, it just is your word. Work hard and keep your word. That's what we do every single day. Everybody did exactly what they said they were going to do, and that really impressed me. I heard about Semper Solaris and found out that they were veterans, so I knew they were going to do the job right.
Declare your energy independence. Choose solar panels made in America. We get the job done right with esprit de corps and honor. Add Tesla Powerwall and prepare for blackouts. Grab the federal 26% solar and battery tax credit. No interest or payments until 2022. Call 877-211-5591. 877-211-5591. Or visit SemperSolaris.com.
26% federal tax credit based on eligibility. Consult your tax advisor. Cannot be combined with any other offers. On approved credit. New customers only. Some restrictions apply. Expire 6/30/2021. CSLV number 07-152.
Nick Gingrich here, and I'd like to invite you to listen to my podcast, Unique Story. Most people know me as a former Speaker of the House, but I'm also a historian with a wide range of interests. I enjoy talking with experts in the field and the most interesting people across a variety of subjects. I release 4 episodes of Unique Story every week with an effort to excite the imagination of our audience, and hopefully you'll learn something new each time you listen. Listen and subscribe for free to New World from the iHeartRadio app or wherever you get your podcasts.
I get on the plane, I go to put my suitcase in above my row. There's a smaller bag in there, so whip it around the other bag, and the flight attendant comes, ma'am. All of a sudden, I realize I'm Ma'am, and she's screaming at me like I'm an unruly passenger.
Gary and Shannon, weekdays at 10 a.m.
I knew what it was seen, dude. She was pissed at me.
On KFI.
KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. What a great song for this weekend. Hope you've got some fun 4th of July plans made. I'm Jennifer Jones Lee. Here's what we're watching in the KFI 24-hour newsroom. The ATF's national response team is on the scene of that massive illegal fireworks explosion that happened when the LAPD's bomb squad was trying to destroy some improvised explosive devices in South LA. The explosion Wednesday night happened after bomb techs loaded those explosives into a total containment vehicle. Then moments later, boom, the special containment vehicle was destroyed. Dozens of cars were damaged. At least 17 people were injured, 10 of whom are police officers. And L.A. City Councilwoman Monica Rodriguez says the city's first fireworks buyback program has seen more than a quarter ton of illegal fireworks being taken off the streets. Under the program, people have been able to turn in their fireworks and get tickets to Dodger games, passes for Universal Studios, and gift cards to a number of retailers. Rodriguez says the fireworks buyback idea is based on L.A.'s gun buyback program. Well, speaking of fireworks, let's talk to the guy who I saw had a quote, "God bless America, we are back." Jim Souza is the CEO of Pyro Spectaculars in Rialto. Jim, good morning to you.
Good morning to you. Good morning.
I could only imagine what last year must have been like for you. When you tell me what that was like, because do you, I assume, get the fireworks way in advance of all the shows, probably a year in advance. Then all of a sudden you've got this stockpile that you're ready to send out to all your shows, and then COVID hits, and then what do you do?
Well, you're right. It takes a year to plan for these events. So we staged on the 4th of July, and yeah, we were ready. We turned to 2020 in January and February. We're looking at the biggest year ever. And then, as everybody knows, the pandemic hit in March. We were hoping for baseball, which is kind of our opening, and that got postponed and eventually canceled, along with cruise lines and theme parks and outdoor live events. Everything canceled all the way through the 4th of July. We were down 90% in our shows. It was very devastating.
Unbelievable. And what do you do? I mean, this is silly questions, but Do fireworks expire? How long do they last? Do they dry out?
No, it's the old saying, keep your powder dry. So we have sophisticated military underground bunkers that they're stored in year-round, and there's really no expiration, but we turn it over every couple of years anyway.
So good. So at least you were able to, I hope then this year, use what you had planned for 2020.
Yeah, we have tons of inventory. We didn't have to buy anything, and we're just really excited right now. We're staging over 250 shows from here all the way to New York to make you stuff with July spectacular.
Wow. Is this more or typical of a year for you?
No, we normally do about 400, so we're about 250, but we're very thankful and grateful to even have that. And that's because everything started late. You know, the vaccine hit, and we're very thankful about that. We're getting vaccinated, and the state opened up on June 15th. So when all that was announced, then everybody started coming in and starting to book. But normally, we're booked in January and February, so this year we started quite late, otherwise we would be there. But we're very happy, and looking down the road is even better.
Okay, you've got 250 shows that you are planning for across the country. Can you give us a hint? Or, you know, it's just me and you talking. Nobody else is listening, of course, right? Which fireworks show here in the Bay, in the Southern California area do you think is the best one? Like, which one have you supplied the most for and you thought, dang, that's going to be a great show?
Well, the great show is sort of the granddaddy of all at the Rose Bowl. We call it America Fest, and that's over a 90-year tradition going on, one of the longest traditions of 4th of July, and they have live entertainment inside the bowl, and huge fireworks, sky concert, and fireworks inside the bowl. So that's the most exciting that I would go to.
Oh, that's awesome. Okay, illegal fireworks have been so much in the news lately, and I think it's so important that people hear you have sophisticated underground bunkers that you store your fireworks in. Not these yahoos down the street who've just got boxes of them in their, garage, and then are surprised when the darn things go off.
Yeah, we're so highly regulated, and we should be, by the ATF, the Department of Transportation, the local, state, all different levels, and everything is accounted for, and there's sophisticated inventory control. And so we have to comply with these, and have to keep everything safe. It's just unfortunate with all these illegal activities that are going on, and they've been going on for years. It's amazing on the 4th of July. Some of them have bigger stuff than we do, and it's unsafe. And I think if you leave it to the professionals like us, everybody gather with family and friends and come out and celebrate Independence Day, one of the professional shows.
I just have a question for you when it comes to the actual lighting of the fireworks. How does that work? So you set up these elaborate, I guess, kind of staging areas of where the fireworks go off, and then how far away are you? How does that work when you want to actually light them?
That's a good question. Let's just take, for example, we're talking about the Rose Bowl. So we're actually launching these devices just out into the golf course. So we have what's called a table of distance, where we have to have a safety zone. So if we're firing shells that are literally like a round ball, 4 inches all the way up to a basketball, like 8 inch, we have to take that, the size of it, by 100 feet. And so we would have an 800-foot radius or 1,000-foot radius of a safety zone. So in the center of all that is a launching site that has these launching mortars, and each one of these mortars has its own shell that goes inside there that has electronic connection. It goes back to a computer terminal. We play music. We synchronize it. We push the button and it all. We make it look really easy when, in fact, we're really fusing together the ancient art of fire with modern technology and blowing things up in the sky, making it a great celebration.
That's what I wondered, too. How do you get it to sync with the music? I mean, is there somebody there who's just got a really good sense of music that's lighting them off, or do you guys have these sort of times? How does that work?
Well, we talk about a year in advance, so we start traveling around the world. We haven't been able to do that this year, but we go around the world about this time, right after the 4th of July, mostly through China, looking at new products and then testing them there, testing them again before they leave, and then we have a really sophisticated program in Southern California and a remote site that we test them one more time. All that information of its launch time, its burn time, its colors, its effects, they're all categorized and cataloged into our computer database, which is stored. And then us as designers and creative people, you know, we look at that, we use another program, a computer program and a simulation of designing it to a music beat and creating different scenes and emotions happiness, joy, excitement, fun. And then that gets all programmed and downloaded into what we call a field controller. And that is the computer that actually sends out the signals to a Sensi time code. And it's all perfectly done to the frame.
All right, what's the 4th of July like for Jim Souza? Do you go around to your different shows, or do you just sit back and go to one show and just watch your work happen in front of you?
I make sure everything's all taken care of. The trucks are on the road. There's no problems. Everybody's happy. And then I will slip out somewhere quietly and watch one of my shows.
Oh, that's awesome. You deserve it. Congratulations. I'm so glad that you guys are back on your way to normalcy. And I cannot tell you how much I love a fireworks show. I don't care if I have to sit in traffic and wait for it and whatever. I will do it. I recently went to one of the Angels game, and that was the first time I'd seen fireworks in over a year or so. It literally made me teary. There's something about fireworks that just hits you in the heart.
Yes, there's little kids and all of us looking to the sky and having the oohs and ahs. It's a magical thing, and very proud to be the fifth generation of a fireworks family that's able to do that for everybody.
Well, thank you very much, and thanks to your family for keeping this going. It's just incredible. Happy 4th of July, Jim. Thanks for getting up early with me.
God bless America. Thank you.
Absolutely. See you later. That is Jim Souza. He is the CEO of Pyro Spectaculars in Rialto. Does that feel good? Even talking about fireworks makes me happy. Dean Sharp, you better have fireworks to talk about when we talk with you next. To be fair to Dean, I kind of feel like we should be charging Dean for this next segment, because his list, he always sends me a list, kind of notes about things that he wants to talk about, right? And the list that he sent me is titled, Important Stuff We Really Need to Know. I'm like, should we pay for this?
Damn right you should.
All right, Dean's going to let us in on that in just a second, and I'll go see what, change I can find around the newsroom. We'll see.
Did I say that on the air?
Yes, you did. All right, Dean's coming up in just a second. Right now, let's take a look at your drive. Robin Banks is checking out the... Sorry, I can't get there fast enough.
That's okay. We're going to the 10 in Ontario. It's on the 10 westbound just after 4th. It's a wreck on the right shoulder, but there is a big rig involved in a couple of cars as well. It's really messing with your morning, starting right around Vineyard. Echo Park, still have trouble here on the 101 south before Alvarado, but it has all been taken over to the right shoulder. Still just a little bit of slowing from Vermont with that one. All the lanes have been opened. Hollywood, also, they have cleared this one on the 101 northbound before Santa Monica Boulevard. Both cars over to the right shoulder. Not going to be a big deal for your drive. It looks like that's gone away. The slowing has. And down to Los Angeles, still have a broken down car on the 110 south at 8th Street on the off-ramp. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robin Hicks.
Where do SoCal drivers go for a super selection of new Hondas and a super experience? The Norm Reeves Honda Superstore. Start with super value when you sell us your vehicle. Then choose from one of the largest Honda inventories in Southern California. Every new Honda is backed by our exclusive price protection guarantee, which states if you can find the same new Honda for less within 5 days, Norm Reeves will pay you the difference or buy your vehicle back. Plus, our friendly team makes car buying effortless and enjoyable. Hurry in for super selection and a super experience during the Norm Reeves 4th of July event. Visit our super award-winning Norm Reeves Honda Superstore locations in Huntington Beach, West Covina, the Irvine Auto Center, and the number one Honda store in the world in the Cerritos Auto Square. Plus, we're now open in Vista. Shop online at normreeves.com. As for Global Honda, new vehicle sales 2020.
SoCal weather from KFI. It is going to be a nice day out there today. A little warm, though. Temperatures will be back in the low 70s at the beaches. Again, just like yesterday, we'll be in the low to mid 80s for Metro LA and OC. We'll be in the low 90s to right in the upper 90s, maybe eke out a couple of hundreds in the valleys in the IE. Then it looks like by the 4th of July, temperatures will just be in the upper 90s. So we'll cool it down a bit. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee.
At Ralph's, we know there's never a good time to run out of fresh. Luckily, our delivery and free pickup make it easy to grab what you need. So whether it's a few extra buns for the backyard barbecue, or some miscellaneous munchies for movie night, we make it easy to get back to being you. Ralph's, fresh for everyone. Free pickup on orders of $35 or more. Restrictions may apply.
Get more ways to save with the Buy 5 or More, save $1 each sale. Just buy 5 or more participating items and save $1 each with card. Ralph's, fresh for everyone.
It is going to be hot, like I just mentioned. So I know for the 4th of July weekend, you might be having people over. So everybody's going to be drinking and using more water at home. But don't go out there and buy a couple of cases of plastic bottled waters. Just give Life Source a call and get a refreshed filtered water system coming out of every single tap in your house. Then you wouldn't have to worry about those plastic water bottles all over the place. Plus, when you get a Life Source system, it's going to reduce the odor and taste of chlorine in your water, and it does it without using salt or chemicals. So you'll be bathing and showering without the drying effects of chlorine on your skin and hair. You're going to get enough chlorine on your skin and hair in the pool. You don't need it when you're in the shower, too. And with Life Source water, every faucet becomes a convenient place to get that clean, delicious water. And speaking of convenience, these whole house systems are maintenance-free, so you don't have to worry about filters or monthly exchange tanks. And if you have hard water, they have a solution. With Life Source water, you're buying directly from the factory, and all the products are made in the USA. And speaking of the USA, right now, in celebration of 4th of July, Life Source water will pay your sales tax. You can take advantage of huge savings and experience filtered water for your entire home, but this offer ends soon, so act today. Call Life Source today and get full service and full confidence in your water. Call them at 1-800-334-5009. That's 1-800-334-5009. Or just visit LifeSourceWater.com. Life Source Water. Taste and feel the difference.
Just graduated this year like I did? Then grab your travel bud for an epic trip. Avelo Airlines is giving away 500 round-trip tickets to celebrate the class of 2021. Because you deserve it. Register at Avelo before July 20th. Restrictions may apply. Visit AveloAir.com.
There's never been a better time to switch to Spectrum Mobile. You could save hundreds of dollars on your mobile bill. Plus, there are no added taxes, hidden fees, and no contracts. Try the Spectrum Mobile Savings Calculator today, and in 3 easy steps, you'll see how much you could save by switching. Visit SpectrumMobile.com/save. Spectrum Internet required. Savings may vary. Restrictions apply. Visit SpectrumMobile.com/save for details.
American Vision Windows, SoCal's choice for energy-efficient windows and doors. AmericanVisionWindows.com.
Live and local.
KFI AM 640.
An iHeart radio station.
AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeart Radio app. Welcome to your holiday weekend. I'm Jennifer Jones Lee, and some of the stories we're watching in the KFI 24-hour newsroom. The recall election of Governor Newsom has been set for September 14th. California's lieutenant governor set the date once election officials certified enough valid signatures had been turned in to qualify the recall effort for the ballot. Had to be an awkward conversation. Hi, Governor Newsom. This is your lieutenant governor. I set the date for your recall. Have a great weekend. Health Director Barbara Ferrer says she's concerned about the rapid spread of the COVID-19 Delta variant. She says 47% of all new cases in LA County have a Delta strain. News is brought to you by Duffy Power Services. Let's talk now with the man who likes to talk about Duffy Power Services. It's Dean Sharp, KFI's House Whisperer. You can listen to Dean tomorrow morning from 6 to 8 here on KFI Sunday morning from 9 to 11 for those of us who are lazy. Hi, Dean. Good morning.
Good morning. I do like to talk about Duffy.
You do, and you do a wonderful job.
They're one of my favorite companies. Thank you.
Okay. When I read the title of your list, important stuff you really need to know, I thought, good Lord, we owe him for this.
Well, you know, I hope everything I share every week, is relatively important. But I probably should have named this list Dean's list of things that really piss him off.
Oh.
So it's kind of that thing. It's there are some things that folks need to know that I constantly run into homeowners not knowing. And I don't blame the homeowner. I blame the builders and the designers and the professionals, the construction industry professionals who are in their life who are not informing of these things. Some of them are absolute game changers. Some of them are just important. And so I thought, you know what? It's about time that I actually compiled this list, and that's what we're talking about all weekend long.
All right, I'd like to begin with what on this list peeves you the most? What is the one thing on your list of important stuff we really need to know that you say, God bless America, fix this?
Well, there are things on the list here that are legal in nature that are really important. There are also things that are just part of the design and construction process. And of all the things, nothing gets to me more than floor surfaces that have not been laid flush to each other.
So where you've got that little lip or there's that tiny little trip factor going from one room into another.
I don't mind the teeniest, tiniest little factor because sometimes, you know, we're working on a slab and the flooring material that's in the hall is slightly, you know, shorter than the flooring, than the tile that's going in the bathroom. So a tiny little transition that if you're barefoot, you can, you know, barely detect that transition. That's, you know, nobody's tripping on that. And it's not a big deal. What I'm talking about usually happens when a contractor is just downright lazy and we decide, you know what, the new flooring that's going in the bathroom or the new flooring that's going in the hallway, we're just going to lay it on top of the old stuff and create like a half inch or 5/8 or sometimes 3/4 inch transition between one room to the next. And the thing that gets to me is the fact that it's almost, always avoidable, but people don't step up to do it.
Why would it? So it's laziness, I would assume. Are there people who are like, hey, I know that we would have to change the, what do you call it, subfloor, I guess, and lumber's expensive right now, and we don't want to put that out, so just do what you can to make it look good.
Yeah, well, I mean, the whole lumber is expensive right now thing is not an excuse, because this has been happening for as long as I've been in the building industry, so that's not an issue. Although lumber is expensive right now. But, yeah, it's laziness on the part of the contractor. You know what I think it really is? I mean, they're going to get paid for it. Sometimes, legitimately, the builder will present this to the client, and the client will be like, nah, okay. And at that point, shame on you, because for whatever extra little time it's going to spend, a couple of days prepping the floor, for whatever extra cost, and it's just really labor cost, you're going to be living with this floor for the next 20 or 30 years. And that's my point. That's
you can put point. Up with 2 days, people. Two days is not going to kill you when it is, you know, that's your, what, your cost, and then your reward is 30 years?
Yeah. So I always ask my clients, I'm like, hey, I understand. Whenever we run into an additional cost, and we try our best to keep costs down, and I'm not generaling these days, but I, as a designer, I ask my clients, you know what? Think about this. Are we going to care? I understand. Are you going to care 3 or 4 years from now that you shelled out a few extra $100 in regards to your budget 3 or 4 years from now? Because I know damn well you're going to care 3 or 4 years from now when you're still walking up over that ramp.
Yeah, absolutely you are.
And so that's the thing. So just know, please, if you're listening, if you're having a floor installed, if you're considering having a floor installed, have the conversation about how do we get this new floor surface as level as possible with the old one. Because there's a way. I guarantee you, there's a way.
Okay, I kind of have a relationship with my garbage disposal, and it's one that my husband thinks is a little dysfunctional because I can't tell you how many times he screams, that does not go down the garbage disposal! And you say garbage disposals aren't that great of an idea. Is it because of people like me? You can say yes. It's okay.
Sure. I mean, if I'm in your house, here's the thing. If I was voicing everything like I did at the beginning of the segment, because at 5:30, Dean has no inner monologue. So if you caught me at 5:30 in the morning, I'm the guy standing in your kitchen saying, is it water? Okay, that's fine. If it's anything else, it does not go down the garbage disposal, which kind of defeats the purpose of the garbage disposal. But here's the thing. Garbage disposals are a 1950s, 1960s concept. We've been living with them for quite a while. We got a lot of them in the U.S. Roughly 50% of the households in the U.S. have garbage disposals. You go outside the U.S. For a long time now, it's about 6% of folks in Canada, About the same-ish in the UK and throughout Europe. Garbage disposals have now been banned throughout Europe. They're not used whatsoever.
I didn't know that.
They've been banned in places like New York City as well. And here's why. It's not because everybody wants you to do more work. It's because your garbage disposal creates from the food that you're shoving down its throat a sludge, a kind of sludge. Think about not what you see in your sink, but what happens on the other side of the garbage disposal. It creates a bio sludge. That sludge is the bane of existence for a lot of wastewater management districts because they have to work very, very hard to additionally clean the wastewater and process it. In addition, that's just when it gets to the wastewater facility. But in addition to that, what's happening in between your garbage disposal and the wastewater facility is that sludge is building up. It's building up in sewer pipes. It's building up in your sewer pipes. If your sewer pipes are already old, it's taxing them. It really is putting pressure on them. And so the problem is that I can foresee, and this is not a prophecy, a foolproof prophecy, but I can foresee a time in the very near future when everybody is going to have to let go of their garbage disposal because wastewater management districts are just going to say, nope, no, 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 we're done. We're done with that. Please put garbage where it belongs, in the garbage. So instead of just dumping everything down the throat of the sink and letting the garbage disposal take care of it all, from our perspective, you pull out the compost bin, you pull out a trash can, and you scrape off your plates before they go into the sink.
Okay, now I don't know if I feel worse because I'm creating such a hassle for the sewer system or if I just know that I see my relationship breaking up in the future and I'm already mourning it.
Either is possible, Jen, but just accept the fact that you're a sludge meister.
I am a sludge meister. Okay, what is wrong with pocket doors? They're adorable.
Pocket doors are great. There's nothing wrong with pocket doors except cheap pocket door hardware, meaning the actual pocket, the frame that a pocket door hangs in, has been sold so pervasively for the last 30 to 40 years that pocket doors now have a reputation of being terrible. In other words, that they get stuck, they come off their track, they go out of adjustment, they roll funny, they make noise, you name it. I've heard every complaint about pocket doors. Now, as a designer, there are times when it's just perfect to put a pocket door in, a door into a small bathroom, a door into a tight closet, anywhere where the swing of a door actually gets in the way of the process and takes up space. And so I love pocket doors, but I wish everybody knew, because I always get pushback from pocket doors. I'm like, yeah, Dean, I don't know if I want to put a pocket door in. That's kind of cheap, and it's going to be like, no, it's as good a door as any other door. By the way, there is no specific door for a pocket door. Any door you want hangs and rolls and can become a pocket door. The track is the thing. And so I just say this, if you haven't spent $150 to $170 or more on the pocket, the hardware that the door hangs on, then yeah, you're going to be disappointed and have trouble in the end. When you go to the big box store and there's a $35 pocket door hardware kit sitting there in the door aisle, just keep on walking.
Dean, thank you so much. I like how passionate you are about these.
They just really get under my skin because it's the kind of stuff that we would like to get on to the real fun stuff. And I just find myself repeating it again and again and again, project after project. And eventually, you know, it builds up.
Like the sludge.
Yeah.
And there it all came full circle. Dean, thank you as always. Have a great weekend. Happy 4th of July.
Thanks. You too, Jim.
Thanks. See you later. Dean Sharp, KFI's House Whisperer. You can follow him on social media at Home with Dean. Or just listen to him tomorrow morning from 6 to 8 a.m. and Sunday morning 9 to 11. All right, let's talk entertainment news when we come back with ABC's Jason Nathanson. We actually have a busy weekend for new movies. So you've got The Tomorrow War, that's the Chris Pratt movie, that's coming out. You've got a new Steven Soderbergh thriller coming out. So there's a lot to talk about. Zola, which I hear is very funny, And that one's on the list, too, so all that straight ahead. Right now, let's check out this stall on the 5.
Good Buena Park on the 5 north out of Valley View. Somebody broke down in the left lane, so a slight pause for you right around Artesia Boulevard. Santa Fe Springs, 605 southbound at the 5 freeway. Somebody here with a flat tire, they are in the gore point, so just use caution if you're making that transition and you see that vehicle there changing a tire. In Ontario on the 10 westbound just after 4th, wreck on the right shoulder now, a big rig and a car collided, so a little bit of slowing is all you're going to have to endure. In Colton on the 10 eastbound at the 215, report of a brush fire up against the off-ramp right shoulder, so we'll keep an eye on that for you. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Robin Bay.
This report is sponsored by Whole Foods Market. At Whole Foods Market, get animal welfare certified baby back pork ribs for $6.99 a pound through July 6th, plus an extra 10% off for Prime members while supplies last. Learn more on the Whole Foods Market app.
This is Chris Collinsworth. Here's what's trending on the iHeart Sports Network, presented by DraftKings.
Sha'Carri Richardson may miss the Tokyo Olympics after testing positive for marijuana. The American sprinter won the 100-meter race in the track and field trials. Dodgers manager Dave Roberts said Trevor Bauer will start Sunday despite his sexual assault allegations. And former USC star Reggie Bush wants his Heisman Trophy back. The move comes after the NCAA granted rights for college athletes to profit off their name, image, and likeness. I'm Misty Jordan.
Download the DraftKings app and use code SPORTS to get a free shot at millions of dollars up for grabs this week with your first deposit.
Minimum $5 deposit required. Eligibility restrictions apply. See DraftKings.com for details.
Thinking of buying a house and want a really low interest rate? Owning has a special for home purchases, where Owning pays all your closing costs, and the rate and APR is an unheard of 1.875% for a 15-year fixed mortgage with 20% down. This is the craziest low rate for a mortgage with no closing costs that Owning has ever done. 1.875% rate and APR. Heck, we're almost paying you to live in a new house. Call 833-2-OWNING or go to owning.com to see if you qualify for this crazy low 1.875% rate. That's a fixed rate loan at 1.875% with no closing costs. Call 833-2-OWNING now, because 1.875 could go away at any time.
NMLS 2611, licensed by the Department of Financial Protection and Innovation under the California Residential Mortgage Lending Act. Subject to credit approval. Offer assumes the use of lender's choice escrow and title services. Call 833-858-0066 for terms and conditions.
That's 833-2-OWNING or owning.com. 833-2-OWNING or owning.com.
Let me be straight with you. This is a radio commercial for 3 small business insurance. The policy has no fine print. It's clear what's covered. So while you can't see the following scene, just know that this pet store is protected by 3.
Joe, did you leave the snake tank open?
Look, I don't want to point fingers, but yes.
I'm calling my lawyer.
They're going to need some help with this mess. Luckily, they have 3. No fine print, just exceptional coverage. 3 is a product of Berkshire Hathaway Direct Insurance Company. 3, no nonsense, just common sense.
There are no limits to what we can do together. So let's keep rising, California. Get vaccinated and wear a mask when it can protect you and others. Your actions save lives. To learn more, visit covid19.ca.gov.
In 2007, Marine First Lieutenant Travis Manning was killed in Iraq after saving his wounded teammates. Travis's legacy lives on through the 5 words he spoke before leaving for his final deployment. If not me, then who? Words that today fuel the spirit of Travis Manning Foundation. Words that live in veterans, families of the fallen, and inspired civilians who go out of their way to find a way, who help others with the help of others, who bounce back after each setback, who make good on good intentions. Through Travis Manning Foundation, if not me, then who, are words that can live in you too. Show the world what your character is made of, because character is invisible until it's not. Find out how you can strengthen the character of your community alongside empowered veterans, families of the fallen, and inspired civilians at TravisManion.org. That's TravisManion.org.
Your kitchen sink is clogged, so you call a handyman. He pulls up in an old dented truck, but that's okay, because he's cheap. He tracks mud, or what looks like mud, across your carpet, but that's okay, because he's cheap. He puts his dirty tools on your kitchen counter where you prepare food, but that's okay, because he's cheap. Hello, I'm John McClan, owner of Rooter Hero Plumbing. We can clean that same drain for only $77. And we'll treat your home like it's your castle, because it is. Rooter Hero will clean your drain, treat you like a king or queen, and we'll do it for only $77. That's how we came up with our phone number, 866-DRAIN-77. And here's my promise to you. If Rooter Hero doesn't live up to your expectations, then call me. 866-DRAIN-77. My personal cell phone number is on every business card. You can also reach us at rooterhero.com.
When it comes to looking out for your business, Bay Alarm brings the best. Like a networked video surveillance system accessible from anywhere. Because if your security's not the best, you're not secure. Now, more than ever, Bay Alarm. ACO28CCL880138.
Tickets are on sale now for our 2021 iHeartRadio Music Festival. September 17th and 18th in Las Vegas. Billie Eilish, Cheap Trick, Coldplay, Dua Lipa, Florida Georgia Line, Journey, Khalid, Lil Baby, Maroon 5, Nelly, Sam Hunt, Weezer, and more on the T-Mobile Arena nighttime stage. Get tickets now through AXS.com. That's AXS.com.
Portions of the following program were pre-recorded.
Everybody is a mixed-race couple, have you noticed, in TV commercials?
And they're adding a lot of gay people.
Or it just feels like that because of for how long...
That's true. I'll buy that.
...people weren't represented.
Okay, that resonates.
Bill Handel. Mornings from 6 to 10 on KFI.
KFI AM 640 Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. Welcome to the start of your holiday weekend. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee, and some of the stories we're watching in the KFI 24-hour newsroom. America's employers added 850,000 jobs in June. This is well above the average of the previous 3 months. And a lot of analysts say, hey, this is a good sign that companies might be having an easier time finding enough workers to fill jobs. So today's report from the Labor Department was the latest sign that the reopening of the economy is propelling a pretty good rebound from the pandemic recession. 5:57 on your wake-up call. Jason Nathanson, good morning to you. So I hear you're working this weekend. You are pressing play.
Yes, I'm pressing play. A special that hosted for ABC Radio all about playing, whatever form that might take for you. For me, I went undercover as a pickleball player, deep undercover, and I became addicted by pickleball. I mean, it is. I'd never really heard of it 4 months ago. Started playing it with a friend, and it is just I absolutely love it. Playing at the public courts here in LA in the Valley, it is so much fun. So, if you haven't played pickleball before, I highly recommend you check it out.
I've got to say, I've never played pickleball before. I don't know that I've known anyone who was a pickleball player.
It's got a really silly name, and I know people think of it as kind of weird, but it's this great mix of tennis and kind of ping pong, and it's just a lot of fun, and you can pick it up really easily, and so you feel really confident at the beginning, but it's really social as well. One park I know, there might be Bloody Marys on Saturday morning.
What? Okay. Maybe. All right, now you're speaking my language. Exactly. Now that sounds like a pickleball game I can get into. So you're hosting a 3-hour 4th of July special press play this weekend on ABC.
Yeah, it's on ABC. It'll be on ABC News Live. It'll be on a podcast form and some other places as well. And if you want a preview of the pickleball segment, which is fantastic, you actually get to see me play a little pickleball. That's on my Twitter at ABC News Jason.
Okay, now let's talk about once people are done watching you press play this weekend, what can they watch? And this is one, I think this is the movie that I have seen advertised the most. Like, it's the one that I felt like, okay, we're back in the game. I feel normalcy now, because everywhere you look, you see the posters for The Tomorrow War.
Yeah, but tomorrow, and for good reason, because I think Amazon reportedly spent $200 million to buy it from Paramount.
Wow.
Which is a lot of money. And this is a Chris Pratt sci-fi epic that really would feel at home on any big screen. It was meant to be a big screen movie, and now it's on Amazon Prime Video. And a lot of these movies, once they come to Netflix or they debut on Netflix or some of the streaming services, I feel like, okay, I understand why this is on a streaming service. It might not have been a big hit on the big screen. This feels like a big movie, like it would have been maybe a big deal on the big screen. It's a sci-fi, time travel, alien battle type action adventure starring Chris Pratt, who is, you know, I would literally watch him in, I think, anything.
Me too.
J.K. Simmons also co-stars, Yvonne Strahovski, Betty Gilpin, so you got a great cast. And it's got a little bit of a feel of one of my favorite sci-fi kind of movies like this, Edge of Tomorrow, starring Tom Cruise and Emily Blunt.
Oh, yeah.
Which is a fantastic, I think highly underrated film. This feels a little bit about that. Chris Pratt, he plays a guy, he's a teacher, he's a science teacher, and people from 30 years in the future come back. They all of a sudden come back. They figured out time travel. And they're fighting a war against aliens 30 years in the future. And they come back because they need people to fight the war with them. That's how bad the war is going. So they recruit people to come back.